Hello, I've just been reading about the poppy burning. If some of you haven't heard what the poppy burning is, it was something that took part last year involving a Muslim group who pretty much were seen as extremists in some ways. They were burning poppies and things like this kind of thing. I really don't understand how the group work, and I don't think I really want to. Pretty much, they were burning poppies to start their protest on things, and it kind of surprised me in some ways. I mean, I'm not being racist, discrimination of religions and all this. I mean, I've actually got quite a lot of respect for Muslims in some aspects, but there's what I would call the good Muslims and the bad Muslims, the naughty ones that include the ones that are burning poppies and just trying to make hell. For heroes is the exact word as they called it on the papers. Yeah, so they've been hanging around causing problems and things. Remembrance Day, help. They're actually holding like a really protest called Hail for Heroes Day. A protest on Remembrance Day, however, they've just banned it. And it kind of makes me think now, in some ways, our modern society is now here. One of them got found. £50 for burning a poppy. However, you go into a Muslim at Crusade and somebody named a teddy bear, I don't know if you remember this, the teddy bear that was named Mohammed. Now, this was an insult to their beliefs and Allah, in the exact words. But what I don't understand is they're quick enough on us giving us whips and all this if we don't obey to their rules, but £50 we can. They can disobey our rules. It's just really ridiculous. I mean, if I went over to a Muslimic country now and I said, Allah's a fake fucking prophet, he deserves to fucking die, he's a scummy bastard like that, I would be fucking executed for that. You know? And it's kind of like, how do you win? You can't. But you know, you do get some good Muslims as well. You know, I've got a lot of respect for Muslims. I believe they've got beliefs like we've got Christianic beliefs, and I'm very agree with their thought of them sharing money between their more poorer members in their community. I think it's a very good idea. But to go around burning things, this terrorist group said, "Oh, it's well, I call it, practically I call it a terrorist group myself." Going around calling themselves different names, the Muslims Against Crusade, as they're calling themselves at the moment, or MAC, as I prefer to call them. I prefer PC because they're a lot better than MACs. In that case, PC and MAC, well, Muslims Against Crusade, MAC, and pretty much PC, you know, it's get it, PC and MAC? PC's always going to beat the MAC. See if you can work that joke out. Some of you won't get it, but I'm pretty sure some of you will. So they call themselves Ali Gibra. I can't pronounce it. The same sect, Ali Majorian and Islam for UK. But it is pathetic. I mean, these guys shouldn't be allowed to do this, and they. Preferably, I think in Islamic belief, you should be ashamed of yourselves because it's people like you that make people racist towards the Muslims. These days now, you could, I'm not being harsh. Once upon a time, you would think you say the word things that you do you associate with a Muslim, you just say Allah. These days, you say to people names that you associate a Muslim, terrorist, bomb. Immediately, that is the first word that people will react with now. In this society. However, with Muslims, I reckon they say name the first thing about Christian, they'll go killers, murderers, like that. And it is a shame that they didn't say social groups have broken down. There was a time once that Muslimic and Christians did actually get on, even against their beliefs, but that no longer exists. Which is a shame and it sucks. But what else can we do? I mean, we can't exactly. It sounds harsh, we can't control this group all the time, but. Seriously, Muslims against Crusade, Mac. I feel you guys should be ashamed of yourselves, and perhaps consider all those war veterans that have died, and understand where we're coming from. I mean, now, if I, for instance, I don't know, I had a picture of Mohammed, for instance, and I got my lighter and I went like that and burned him, picture him, any Muslim that's watching would be going absolutely bonkers, and my video would probably be taken offline and I'd get my strike for it. Hopefully not a strike with a whip. But, you know, so how does everybody else see about this Islamic protest? You know, this group, Muslims against Crusade groups, is it right they act like this? Are they in the wrong? Are they even in the right? What do you guys reckon, you know? Should all these kind of people, this kind of belief, be kicked out of England? Should they all be sent back to their Islamic countries? And in my opinion, freedom of speech, anyone that wants to promote terrorism that are Islamic, and anyone wants to promote terrorism that's English in a Islamic country, should be deported back to their own country. We don't need it here. I believe, yes, immigranting is a good thing in some ways. But why bring idiot Muslimic terrorists like this into England? Can anyone tell me that? Oh, sorry, I blame the Home Secretary for getting these in, but this is what I'm on about. This country is falling to fucking pieces because they have no control over things like Muslims against Crusade. There'll be something else. They'll change the name. They'll be back within a few weeks. I know. Muslim up your ass Crusade and all this. Muslim up gets on your nerves Crusade. They'll come up with something new. And this ban thing will not stop them. There needs to be a law in place to stop them from acting. A proper law that bans this. I'm also against the burqa being banned in England. I don't think the burqa should be banned. And also what's going to do now is a Muslim thing and stick a balaclava over their head. They've done it again. Pretty much, that's how you get around it. And I think the burqa should be allowed back in England. Myself, and I think it's wrong to ban it. But there we go. This is how the world has changed. So I'm not on England's side. I can understand England more than I can understand the Muslim side, but I also can understand the Muslimic side. So what's your opinions?